good news according to John. Jesus said, "Very truly I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Those who love their life lose it. And those who hate their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me. And where I am, there also will my servant be. Whoever serves me, the Father will honor." Sisters and brothers, this is ours, this is yours, the gospel, the good news of the Lord. Please be seated. How are you doing? You're doing well. Day 9, our final day. And it's been wonderful. Have you enjoyed it? And I just want to say thank you. And it's just been lovely meeting so many different people. Seeing you share your faith, your gentleness, your good sense of humour, and let's take that with us beyond our arena. And of course, happy feast day today, day of St. Gerard, our day as well. And we want to thank you for your generosity in contributing to the Dundalk Heart Club, the blessing of babies, that collection on last Sunday. It raised 2,100. So thank you. Please continue to put your names in the remembrance box and you'll find that at St. Gerard's Shrine, and that's for the special Mass on next Sunday evening at 7 p.m. Did you take a Novena selfie? Look your hand. I've a church full of liars. Because I know some of you, a few women took some with me. Let them be secret. So can I draw your attention? Do you see St. Gerard? Not over there, but over here. You seen him? Is there something special about him? You're in there. There are over 1,100 of you, photos of you within that beautiful image and picture of St. Gerard. Isn't it wonderful? And the brains behind that and the hard work behind that were our students or seminarians. That we're very proud of as well. So after Mass, you might take a stroll up and just have a look in there, and you might even meet yourself. Tickets are sale in the monastery reception for the Lingbom Christmas concert, a beautiful concert that costs €20, and it's on the 8th of December. And now, any religious objects with you? It might be your husband or wife beside you. It might not. So if you want to take them out, you don't have to take them out of their wrappers. We pray. Dear Father, we thank you for your goodness to us. Stretch out your compassionate hands over these gifts that we present to you for blessing. Lord, you know we need symbols and signs and gifts to remind us of your love for us and to deepen our commitment to you. Bless each of these. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Who is the person who inspires you the most in your life? Who is the person who inspires you the most in your life? Think about it for a moment. Who is the one who raises you up to be more than you can be? When I'm down and oh my soul so weary, when troubles come and my heart burdens me, then I am still and wait in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. You raise me up to more than I can be. You recognize the song? You raise me up. And recently I listened to Brian Kennedy sing this inspiring song. And you know, it made me think about the people who inspired me, who have helped me in the storms of my own life to try to be the best I can be in my life and in my faith. One of my favorite TV programs are the annual People's Awards. Have you ever seen them? Keep an eye out for them. These are not the Oscars celebrating famous actors and movie celebrities, but instead, these are chosen by the people to honor ordinary people in Ireland who have shown extraordinary goodness in their lives. Two of these who won awards in the last couple of years have particularly inspired me. I'd like to share them with you. The first one is a girl called Joanna Reardon. Have you ever heard of Joanna? She's quite a gutsy girl, I can tell you. She's from County Cork. And Joanna inspires me simply because of her stick-at-itiveness, her sense of perseverance against all the odds. Joanna is an ordinary 18-year-old in some ways. She's got strong opinions, has a devilish and a wicked sense of humour. And she relishes breaking through the limits and the barriers of her life. But what's most unique about Joanne is that she's only one of seven people in the world who lives with total amelia, a condition that has left her born without arms and legs. Can you imagine? Faced with indescribable challenges, Joanne continually perseveres with not only living her life, but by climbing the mountains of everyday obstacles. Joanne has been a champion and a strong voice for those who are living with disability. Joanne has even challenged our Irish government after they personally promised not to cut funding for the disabled. And she embarrassed them into a public, humiliating U-turn. Joanne addressed the United Nations in New York. And she was hailed as inspirational because she challenged those world industrial leaders to take out their checkbooks and to build her a life robot to help people in her situation. It was my mother. It was my mother who put me in front of a computer at 2 years of age, she said. Recently, she has achieved a scholarship for University College Cork, and her brother has even made a movie about her. It is called No Limbs, No Limits. The other person who has inspired me in the last couple of years, because of her faith and her commitment, is Katie Taylor. Have you ever heard of Katie? Katie grew up in County Wicklow. She battled hard, despite the challenges, as a world-class sportswoman. Katie is currently the Irish, European, world, and Olympic champion in her weight division in boxing. Katie attributes her faith and her commitment to God. She's made no secret of her love for God. After every single boxing match, that woman publicly thanks God. After one important match, She said, I am an Olympic champion, but Jesus is a champion of champions, she said to the speechless journalist. Let's be honest about it. We Irish Catholics can be so shy about expressing our faith publicly, can't we? There's an example of it. The pastor in her church has said Katie has a strong relationship with God. She's not embarrassed to come out and say it. St. Gerard is a powerful inspiration we can turn to. Do you know that Gerard had several storms and high mountains to climb in the journey of his life? Indeed, like Joanne has it had in her life, without the use of limbs. Did you know that Gerard was rejected when he started applying to join the Redemptorists? And yet, Gerard, like Katie, had tremendous faith and commitment in God. You know the story. Gerard was born into poverty. He had poor health, and it affected even his education, ability to learn, and yet like Joanne, and like Katie, he had a strong faith and a strong determination. He never gave up the fight. He persevered. At 12 years of age, his father died, and as a little boy, can you imagine, he became the breadwinner, became a tailor, opened a business, and reached out to the poor, to the forgotten. Even when his health was going down the drain, Gerard really tried, as you do in your life, to really live the spirit of today's gospel. And you know this in your life. You have made so many sacrifices when you think about it. And Jesus reminds us that there is indeed a price to be paid in trying to do God's will. The sacrifice is to be made. Listen to the words of Jesus. Unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. When we think about it, St. Gerard, Joanna Reardon, Katie Taylor, and you and I, we've all climbed mountains of obstacles in our lives, haven't we? And yet, we all have come through those storms and paid the price. Through it all, God has raised each of them and has raised us, has raised you to be more than you could have imagined you could be. St. Gerard is beautiful source of inspiration for us. Gerard, you are our friend. You are our brother. And as each of us here goes forth from your novena, each of us here wants to thank you. Please continue to help us through the storms of our lives and inspire each one of us as we journey ever closer to God. May the Lord raise all of us up to be more than we can be. In the Father, and the Son, and the Spirit. Amen. We pray with Gerard.